Hello students, today we are going to discuss about food standards. We will be discussing about national and international standards of food quality under this chapter. Why we should learn about standards? Because standards will provide us a guide to design and manage manufactured food regulatory program. They also provides a foundation for a program. And it is a tool to evaluate the effectiveness of food safety interventions. They provides best practices of a high quality manufactured foods regulatory program. They help in expansion of manufactured food regulatory program standards and retail food regulatory program standards. They creates shared data standards to enable exchange of enforcement data among public health and regulatory partners. These are some of the important Indian standards. Agricultural Produce Grading and Marketing Act, that is AGMARC, Fruit Product Order, Solvent Extracted Oil, De-oiled Meal and Edible Flour Control Order, Edible Oils Packaging Order, Vegetable Oil Products Order, Prevention of Food Adulteration Act, Milk and Milk Product Amendment Regulations, Meat Food Products Order, Standards of Weights and Measures Act, Bureau of Indian Standards, Consumer Protection Act, the Environment Protection Act, the Insecticide Act, Plant Food and Seed Order, Export Act, Essential Commodities Act, Agricultural and Processed Food Products Export Development Authority, that is APEDA, Organization Boards, etc. And also we'll be discussing about Food Safety and Standards Act of 2006. This includes International Organization for Standardization, that is ISO standards, Codex Alimentarius Commission, Food and Agricultural Organization, Food and Drugs Administration, Food, Drug and Cosmetic Act. All these acts we'll discuss one by one. The important rules of these acts we will discuss now one by one. First, if you take Agricultural Produce Grading and Marketing Act under National Act, this is an acronym of agricultural marketing. AGMARC is a quality certification mark provided by the Government of India. This certification confirms that the product or commodity, in better term, is scientifically laid down. It confirms the quality control and the best hygienic condition of the food. Then comes the Fruit Product Order, which is introduced in the year 1955. This Fruit Product Order, promulgated under Section 3 of the Essential Commodities Act 1955, with an objective to manufacture fruit and vegetable products, maintaining sanitary and hygienic conditions in the premises and quality standards laid down in the order. This order was earlier implemented by Ministry of Food Processing Industry and now it is FSSAI. This is through the Directorate of Fruit and Vegetable Preservation and the headquarters is located at New Delhi. Then the next act or order is Solvent Extracted Oil, De-oiled Meal and Edible Flour Control Order, which is implemented from the year 1967. The order is basically a quality control order to ensure that the solvent extracted oils in particular are not reached to the consumers for consumption before the same are refined and conformed to the quality standards specified in the order for the purpose. Standards for the solvent, generally hexane, which is to be used for extraction of oil from the oil bearing materials, have also been specified so as to eliminate possible contamination of oil from the solvents used. Now we will discuss about edible oils packaging, which is introduced in the year 1998. In order to ensure availability of safe and quality edible oils in packed form at predetermined prices to the consumers, the central government has introduced this Edible Oils Packaging Act during the year 1998. Then next comes Vegetable Oil Products Order 1998. The vegetable oil products industry is regulated By this order, through the Directorate of Vanaspati, Vegetable Oils and Fats, Department of Food, Public Distribution, Ministry of Consumer Affairs and Food and Public Distribution. These two orders, that is Vegetable Oil Products Order 1947 and Vegetable Oil Products Standards of Quality Order 1975, have been replaced by a single order called Vegetable Oil Products Regulation Order 1998 for proper regulation of manufacture, distribution and sale of vegetable oil products. Then another important act is Prevention of Food Adulteration Act 1954. This act was promulgated by Parliament in 1954 to make provision for the prevention of adulteration of food along with the Prevention of Food Adulteration Rules 1955, which was incorporated in 1955 as an extension to the Act. Broadly, the PFA Act covers food standards, general procedures for sampling, analysis of food, powers of authorized officers, nature of penalties, and other parameters related to food. It deals with parameters relating to food additives, preservatives, coloring matters, packaging and labeling of foods, prohibition and regulation of sales act, etc. Like FPO, amendment in PFA rules are incorporated with the recommendation made by the Central Committee of Food Standards, which has been set up by central government under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, comprising members from different regions of the country. The provisions of PFA Act and rules are implemented by state government and local bodies as provided in the rules. Prevention of Food Adulteration Act 1954 is also replaced with Food Safety and Standards Act 2006. Then comes Milk and Milk Product Amendment Regulations and Milk and Milk Product Act. Consequent upon delicensing of dairy sector in 1991, under Industrial Development and Regulation Act, the Department of Animal Husbandry, Dairying and Fisheries had promulgated the Milk and Milk Products Order in 1992 under Section 3 of the Essential Commodities Act 1955. The objective of the order is to maintain and increase the supply of liquid milk of desired quality in the interest of the general public and also for regulating the production, processing and distribution of milk and milk products. As per the provisions of this order, any person or dairy plant handling more than 10,000 liters per day of milk or 500 million tons of milk solids per annum needs to be registered with the registering authority appointed by the central government. Meat Food Products Order. It is introduced in the year 1973. Meat and meat products are highly perishable in nature and can transmit diseases from animals to human beings. Processing of meat products is licensed under Meat Food Products Order 1973, which was hitherto being implemented by Ministry of Food Processing Industries. The main objectives are to regulate production and sale of meat food products through licensing of manufacturers, enforce sanitary and hygienic conditions prescribed for production of wholesome meat food products, exercise strict quality control at all stages of production of meat food products, fish products, including chilled poultry, etc. Then comes Standards of Weights and Measures Act 1976. Standards for weights and measures are administered by the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution under the Standards of Weights and Measures Act 1976 and related rules and notifications. All weights or measures must be recorded in metric units and certain commodities can only be packed in specified quantities like weight, measure or number as per this act. These include baby and weaning food, biscuits, bread, butter, coffee, tea, vegetable oils, milk powder and wheat and rice flour. The act is a result of governmental efforts to introduce standards for weighing and measuring commodities to protect consumer interest. The standards of weights and measures are administered by the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. Another important act is Bureau of Indian Standards. BIS 1986. Indian Standards Institution, now known as Bureau of Indian Standards, BIS, is set up on 6th January 1947. BIS is functioning under Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, Government of India. BIS has on-record standards for most of processed foods. In general, these standards cover raw materials permitted and their quality parameters, hygienic conditions under which products are manufactured, and packaging and labeling requirements. Manufacturers are complying with standards laid down by the BIS can obtain an ISI mark that can be exhibited on product packages. Then comes Consumer Protection Act 1986. This extends to the whole of India except the state of Jammu and Kashmir. It promotes and protects the rights of the consumers, such as the right to be protected against marketing of goods and services which are hazardous to life and property, the right to be informed about the quality, quantity, potency, purity, standard and price of goods or services to protect the consumer against unfair trade practices, the right to be assured wherever possible to access to a variety of goods and services at competitive prices, the right to be heard and to be assured that the consumer's interest will receive due consideration at appropriate forums, the right to seek redressal against unfair trade practices or restrictive trade practices or unscrupulous exploitation of consumers, and the right to consumer education. Now comes Export Quality Control and Inspection Act 1963. The Export Quality Control and Inspection Act 1963 was amended in 1984. This act provides sound development of export trade in India through quality control and inspection. Next comes Essential Commodities Act 1955. The main objective of this act is to supply of essential commodities to the public by proper regulation, prevention of black marketing, and making it available to the public at reasonable price. Then comes Agricultural and Processed Food Products Export Development Authority. In brief, we can call it as APEDA 1985. The Agricultural and Processed Food Products Export Development Authority was established by the Government of India under the Agricultural and Processed Food Products Export Development Authority Act. The authority of the Act is Ministry of Consumer and Industry, Government of India. Then other commodity boards include such as Spice Board, Tea Board, Coffee Board, National Dairy Development Board, etc. also provide safety measures for export-oriented food items so as to avoid rejections and detention of consignments not conforming to quality standards. The recent standard of food is Food Safety and Standards Act that is introduced in the year 2006 by the Ministry of Law and Justice, that is Legislative Department. The Food Safety and Standards Bill was passed in 2005. Main purpose of the bill is to lay down science-based standards for articles of food and regulate their manufacture, import, export, storage, distribution and sale to ensure availability of safe and wholesome food for human consumption, and establish Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. It was enacted by Parliament in the 55th year of the Republic of India. Establishment of Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, that is FSSAI, within 3 months from the date of the commencement of this act, by notification in the Official Gazette, the central government established a body known as the Food Safety and Standards Authority of India to exercise the powers conferred on and functions assigned to it under this act. The Food Authority is a corporate body having perpetual succession and a common seal with power to acquire, hold and dispose of property, both movable and immovable also. The head office of the Food Authority is at New Delhi. It may establish its offices at other places in India in future. FSSAI food inspection is very important. The examination by an agency empowered to perform regulatory and enforcement functions of food products or systems for the control of raw materials, processing and distribution. This includes in process and finished product testing to verify that they conform to regulatory requirements. The principal objectives of national food control systems are protecting public health by reducing the risk of foodborne illness, protecting consumers from unsanitary, unwholesome, mislabeled or adulterated food, contributing to economic development of maintaining consumer confidence in the food system and providing a sound regulatory foundation for domestic and international trade in food. Now we will discuss about certain important international standards. First one is Codex Alimentarius Commission, that is FAO and WHO. Latin term Codex means food law or food code. FAO in 1961 and WHO in 1963 passed resolution to establish this Codex Alimentarius Commission. It is possible for joint FAO and WHO food standard program. The Codex Alimentarius Commission is an intergovernmental body that coordinates food standards at the international level. The CAC has proved to be the most successful in achieving international harmonization in food quality and safety requirements. The main objectives are to protect the health of consumers and ensure fair practices in food trade. It has formulated international standards for a wide range of food products and specific requirements covering pesticide residues, food additives, veterinary drug residues, hygiene, food contaminants, labeling, etc. The Codex recommendations are used by governments to determine and refine policies and programs under their national food control system. The CAC was created in 1963 by FAO and WHO to develop food standards, guidelines and related tests such as codes of practice under the joint FAO and WHO food standards program. CAC is recognized by the WTO as an international reference point for the resolution of dispute concerning food safety and consumer protection. According to CAC, traceability should be applied to all or specified stages of the food chain, that is from production to distribution. It should be transparent and made available to the competent authorities of the exporting country upon request. This Codex objectives are to protect the health of consumers, to ensure fair practices in the food trade, to coordinate all work regarding food standards, to determine the priorities and to initiate the preparation of standards and to publish the standards. Codex commodity standards include basic structure and quality factors, weights and measures, labeling, contaminants, hygiene, food additives, methods for analysis. Then we will discuss about International Organization for Standardization, that is ISO certification. The method of quality control consisted largely by physical inspection of the end product against product specification. However, technical specification may not by themselves guarantee that a customer's requirements will be met if there happens to be any deficiency in the specifications or in the organizational system to design and produce the products or service. Consequently, this has led to the development of quality system standards and guidelines that complement relevant product or service requirements given in the technical specifications. It is applicable to all types of organization, independent of product size and country, and ensures consistent improvement of quality. ISO 9000, a quality system. Today, consumer is not quantity oriented but quality oriented instead. Hence, for consumer satisfaction, the manufacturers are focusing on quality products. The quality of particular product is determined by ISO, whose certification is of great importance. A quality system is a mechanism by which a company can organize and manage its resources to achieve, sustain and improve quality economically. The ISO 9000 quality management system is looked at as a system with minimum quality requirements. A quality system is a mechanism by which a company can organize and manage its resources to achieve, sustain and improve quality economically. The benefits of ISO 9000 quality system are, like, it enables the user to identify and plan tasks and their method of performance. It also provides the means of identifying and resolving problems and preventing their reoccurrence, thereby improving conformance. It cuts down the poor quality cost. It generates objective evidence to demonstrate the quality of products and the effectiveness of the systems, and thus builds up confidence among customers. This standard demands training for all personnel performing activities affecting quality and hence improved performance. It reduces the firefighting operations and better job satisfaction. Registration to ISO 9000 is a necessary prerequisite in different countries. It is not a product standard and hence can be used for any type of industry and for companies employing very few persons, as well as whose workforce runs into thousands. It has marketing advantages, recognition and publicity, and reduces liability risk. Then comes ISO 22000, which is introduced in the year 2005. This standard specifies requirements for a food safety management system, where an organization in the food chain needs to demonstrate its ability to control food safety hazards in order to ensure that food is safe at the time of human consumption. It is applicable to all organizations regardless of size, which are involved in any aspect of the food chain and want to implement systems that consistently provide safe product. It means of meeting any requirements of ISO 22000-2005 can be accomplished through the use of internal and external resources. Then comes Food and Agriculture Organization of FAO. The Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations leads international efforts to defeat hunger. Serving both developed and developing countries, FAO acts as a neutral forum where all nations meet as equals to negotiate agreements and debate policy. The mandate and objectives of FAO are: the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations leads to international efforts to defeat hunger. Serving both developed and developing countries, FAO acts as a neutral forum where all nations meet as equals to negotiate agreements and debate policy. FAO is also a source of knowledge and information. The organization helps developing countries and countries in transition modernize and improve agriculture, forestry and fisheries practices and ensure good nutrition for all. The FAO was founded in 1945. Since then, focus has been placed on developing rural areas, which are home to 70% of the world's poor and hungry people. Now we will discuss about Food and Drug Administration guidelines for conduct of clinical trials. This provides FDA policies, provides leadership and direction, contributes to international good clinical practice harmonization activities, plans and conducts training and outreach programs. It serves as a liaison with the HHS Office of Human Research Protection and other federal agencies and external stakeholders committed to the protection of human research participants. The Food and Drug Administration is an agency of the United States Department of Health and Human Services and is responsible for the safety regulation of most types of foods, such as dietary supplements, drugs, vaccines, biological medical products, blood products, medical devices, radiation emitting devices, veterinary products, cosmetics, etc. Like all trade unions, the FDA is a democratic organization. Members elect representatives to sit on the FDA's ruling executive committee as well as the general secretary and the president. Overall, the policy is controlled by the annual delegate conference, which meets every year in May. The objective and purpose of this is aligning quality and business objectives for success. The extra work that goes into building a manufacturing facility when it is FDA regulated includes AED for pediatric patients, FDA strategic action plan. FDA uses EA to standardize and save the consolidation effort. This Food, Drug and Cosmetic Act is the another important act, which is the oldest consumer protection agency in the US federal government. The FDA's modern regulatory functions begin in 1906 with the passage of the Pure Food and Drug Act. The Food, Drug and Cosmetics Act is regulated by the FDA and was passed in 1938 in response to a drug poisoning crisis. The public reaction to this and other disasters led to the passing of this landmark legislation. So students, today we have discussed about the national and international standards involved in food quality management for providing guidance and foundation to evaluate the effectiveness of food safety interventions involved in public health. Thank you.